In 1988, a KGB officer codenamed Max began to provide information on moles who had been planted by the KGB inside U.S. intelligence. Their role was to help the KGB eliminate any Soviet agents working for the United States, to create a blind spot in Moscow for U.S. intelligence for years to come. Well, that information actually led to the arrest of three American intelligence officers working on behalf of the Russians, the FBI, and the CIA. There is still, though, a lingering question. What if it wasn't just those three? What if there was another mole who was never found? Joining us now is Bob Baer, CNN intelligence and security analyst, former CIA operative, and also the author of the new book, The Fourth Man, The Hunt for a KGB Spy at the Top of the CIA and the Rise of Putin's Russia. I'm totally fascinated by this book, Bob. And just by that premise, right, was there another mole? The book is titled The Fourth Man. Absolutely. I'm guessing it's a yes.
Erica, yes, there was. And I've spent 4 years on this. The FBI has been very helpful. The CIA, people in the CIA have told me they have no doubt there was a fourth man. He was at the top of the CIA. His knowledge of counterintelligence allowed him to avoid arrest. And as we speak, the FBI is still assembling evidence on this guy, even after 15 years.
At what cost? What was lost, or, you know, the effects of having this person in there, Bob?
It was devastating. It was worse than Ames, Hansen, or Howard. He, for instance, he gave transcripts of conversations between Yeltsin and Putin. I mean, Yeltsin and Clinton, and took these transcripts from the White House, very top secret, and sent them to Moscow. Putin used those transcripts to effectively blackmail Yeltsin and wedge his way into power. He gave all sorts of military secrets, counterintelligence secrets, you name it. There's never been a better place spy than this guy.
It's amazing, too, to think that, as you just said, that this investigation, right, is basically still ongoing.
It is. As of 3 weeks ago, the FBI was knocking on doors, making sure that they hadn't missed anything. It's at the Eastern District of Virginia right now, the U.S. attorney. They're still looking at it. They'd love to put this guy away. But he played to win. He didn't take money. He didn't pass documents that could be traced. He didn't do any travel that he couldn't account for in the CIA budget. He was good. It's Tinker, Tailor, Soldier, Spy. Only this guy is undoubtedly going to get away.
And what's the connection to Putin here? This, in a way, was Putin's guy.
Yeah, but he was originally recruited by counterintelligence in 1984, so continued in the second chief directorate. That second chief directorate became the FSB, which Putin headed. And the presumption is when these transcripts between Clinton and Yeltsin were leaked, it was Putin himself who took them to Yeltsin and say, we know everything you're doing. Beware, the KGB's everywhere. And at that point, he appoints Putin prime minister and he becomes president. It's a nasty game in Moscow, but he had help from Russians. And this guy, the fourth man, also helped wreck FBI investigations because he knew so much about him. He told the Russians about him. They adjusted for him. And these spies like Ames and Hansen can continue for more years.
And so it brings us to where we are today, right? I mean, you point out that the appointment of Putin, right, led to this, you know, not a black hole, but it led to us not having this intelligence out of Moscow, which can only be described as an intelligence failure, you said. The fact that they didn't see the Putin appointment coming, an intelligence failure on par with Pearl Harbor, and one that is still felt today.
Eric, it is. I mean, look, we didn't see Putin coming because we had no agents around him. They had all been betrayed. And when he comes to power, the ambassador to Moscow told me, I got better intelligence from Moscow taxi drivers than I did the CIA. That's how devastated U.S. intelligence was. He's on the record with that.
Wow.
I mean, it's something. Listen, you want a good thriller to read? Here you go. The Fourth Man. Bob Baer, always great to have you with us. Appreciate it. Thank you.